morning, dear students. Today we will start with a new chapter, that is solution. The first part of this chapter includes the definition of concentration terms that we have already covered in class 11th. And the terms are molarity, molality, mole fraction, mass percentage, and volume percentage. So we will not talk anything about the concentration term. We will directly move to the next important topic of this chapter, that is vapor pressure and Rawls' law. So what's the meaning of vapor pressure? So let me make it clear by the help of this diagram. So here we have taken a closed container filled with water at a particular temperature. You know it very well that evaporation takes place at all the temperature, where liquid water gets converted to water vapor. So same process will take place here. Liquid molecules of the water will be converted to water vapor at a particular temperature. Now here the container is closed. So what will happen? Initially, liquid molecules will be converted to water vapor. After some time, we will be having the maximum concentration of water vapor. So here we can say that the concentration of water vapor will be saturated, because we are having maximum concentration of water vapor. No more increase in the concentration of water vapor will be seen when we will get saturated condition for the water vapor. At this stage, water vapor will be in equilibrium with liquid water, or we can say that rate of evaporation will become equal to rate of condensation. So here we are having maximum concentration of water vapor, which is exerting pressure over the liquid surface. So the pressure exerted by the water vapor above the liquid surface is called vapor pressure. To be more precise in the definition, we can use this definition, and the definition is the pressure exerted by the vapors above the liquid surface in equilibrium with the liquid at a given temperature is called water vapor, is called vapor pressure. So temperature is very important. As we will increase the temperature, vapor pressure will also increase. Because with increasing temperature, evaporation rate increases. More liquid molecules will be converted to water vapor, and we will get the maximum value for vapor pressure at the boiling point of the solvent. So here we can say that the vapor pressure of water will be maximum at 100 degrees Celsius or 373 Kelvin, because it is the boiling point of water. So any solvent exerts its maximum vapor pressure at the boiling point. Now the next phase. What happens if a non-volatile solute is added to water or to any solvent? Non-volatile here means the solute cannot be converted to vapor state. This is the meaning of non-volatile solute. If I am using the term volatile solute, it means solute can be converted to vapor form. So here I am adding a non-volatile solute like sodium chloride common salt, or we can say common sugar, or we can say urea. All these are non-volatile solute. So what happens to the value of vapor pressure if a non-volatile solute is added to water or to any solvent? The answer is very simple. The vapor pressure of the solution will decrease. The value of vapor pressure for the solution, if compared with the pure solvent, will be less. And the reason is very simple. Evaporation is a surface phenomenon. The solvent molecules or the water molecules which are present at the surface gets converted to water vapor. Now, if we consider a solution containing non-volatile solute, then at the surface we will have liquid molecules or water molecules, followed by non-volatile solute molecules, then again water molecules, solute molecules, water molecules, solute molecules, and so on. So the concentration of water molecules or the solvent will decrease at the surface from where evaporation is taking place. As the number of water molecules or solvent molecules will decrease at the surface, so we will get less amount of vapor. If the concentration of vapor will decrease, then the pressure exerted by the vapor over the liquid surface will also decrease. So here, if a non-volatile solute is added to water or any solvent, then its vapor pressure will decrease. More the amount of non-volatile solute added to water or to solvent, less will be its vapor pressure. So we need more concentration or more molecules of water for getting more value for vapor pressure. So vapor pressure can be related with the mole fraction of the solvent molecule or the liquid molecule, that is water here. So PA is directly proportional to XA, which can be written as PA equals to P0A XA, where PA stands for vapor pressure of solvent in solution, or we can say vapor pressure of the solution. Simply, P0A, vapor pressure of pure solvent. It can be pure water. It will be the maximum value because no non-volatile solute is added. It's the pure form. So solvent or water in pure form exerts or gives maximum value for vapor pressure. And XA here is mole fraction of solvent in the solution, or we can say mole fraction of water in solution. More the value of XA, more will be the vapor pressure exerted. So the relation between vapor pressure of solution and mole fraction of solvent or water is called Rawls law. So PA is equals to P0A XA is the mathematical expression for Rawls law. That's all for today. Thank you.